To create this part in 3D, we will simply need polylines. You will see in this video how they will be converted into three-dimensional elements with commands such as Extrude and Revolve. In this example, we can see several rectangles. A rectangle is a certain kind of a closed polyline. Here is one, here's another, and here are more rectangles. In total, we have 6. Here we have a circle. And on the other side, we have 2 closed polylines. Let's now create this part in 3D. We first work with this rectangle whose corners should be rounded. We therefore launch the fillet command to create an arc around corners and use, for example, a radius of 1 mm. We select here and here and press Enter. We do this for the 4 corners of the rectangle. We also create arcs in the lower left corner of the rectangle located around the circle and also for the rectangle that is just behind. As we will now need to use the 3D tools, we switch to the 3D modeling workspace. We choose an isometric view. Let's perform a 12 mm extrusion of the larger rectangle. Now let's move the inner rectangle from the base to the top. We extrude the inner rectangle with a negative value of 0.5 mm. As a result, we have 2 boxes. Then we use Subtract to generate a new shape from the subtraction of the small box. Press Enter. From the large one, press Enter. Here's another rectangle. We extrude it with a negative value of 8 mm. We copy this piece to the other end. Now let's create a thread by revolving this closed polyline. We indicate the axis by 2 points and validate with Enter the default value of 360 degrees. Next, let's create some layers to organize the drawing. We assign colors to the layers. We move this solid to the layer connector and then hide the layer. We also have this polyline that we want to revolve as well. Please pay attention, here we have a small tooth. It is important to reach the desired effect. We launch the revolve command, select the polyline and indicate the axis that will be this one. We move this object to the layer named plastic. Now we again activate the layer connector. We need to relocate this element and for that we simply use the move command with a vector from here to the middle. Let's take the opportunity to move all the 3D elements we created to the correct elevation with respect to the figures that have not yet been extruded. We have some more work with the latest polylines. We extrude the 2 greatest shapes with a height of 5 mm to make a subtract operation between the exterior and the interior solid. And we generate a gap. Next, we move these last 2 figures with the move command and extrude 5 mm. Then again, make a subtraction between them. From a top view, we can use the mirror command for a symmetric copy. although to maintain the original design of the object, we again shall use mirror following this axis and indicate that this time we want to delete the source. Besides, from a top view, we will make a new symmetry of this element to add one on the other side. But this time we need to move it by 8 units. And make a new symmetry. We have achieved a 3D part very easily in a few operations. It's that easy to convert 2D elements, closed polylines, rectangles and circles, into 3D elements through the Extrude and Revolve commands to create threads, and then use basic editing commands such as Move, Copy and Mirror. These are very basic and commonly used 2D features that we also frequently need for 3D.